Right, welcome along to another video. Links to the articles are in the information section of this video. We'll start this week with news out of North Dakota, USA, in the aviation pros. Fargo Jet Center celebrates 25 years in business. Fargo Jet Center celebrated their 25th anniversary in September 2020. FJC was established in 1995 when their sister company, Weather Modification International, moved their headquarters to Fargo, North Dakota, and sought an opportunity to start an aviation service company while supporting their fleet of aircraft. Recently touched on some stories from Carnegie, and there is a webinar podcast on their website, Governance of Stratospheric Aerosol Injection. In this presentation, Ina Moller from Wageningen University introduces key political dynamics around the governance of stratospheric aerosol injection. This was the third of three expert overviews presented in the C2G Learn webinar, Governance of Stratospheric Aerosol Injection. In real clear science, geoengineering, a horrible idea we might have to do. And you can see from the screenshot from the video, sure you've heard the expression before, weather modification and climate engineering is your weather on drugs. And you can see from that image, that looks pretty psychedelic. You can't get more your weather on drugs than that. In the St. Andrews Economist, solar geoengineering, a far-fetched expense or foresightful investment. It is estimated that the annual cost of injecting 1 megaton of sulfur, the proposed estimate to keep global warming at bay into the atmosphere, is $1 to $2 million. The free driver effect describes the phenomenon of a process's direct costs being so incredibly cheap that one nation or even person could have the power to implement it on behalf of others. The prospect of one nation's leader, or simply a billionaire playing God with the Earth's climate, is a terrifying one. In the Science Times, can solar climate intervention alleviate global warming? No. Human activity continues to exacerbate global warming, especially by burning fossil fuels for energy. Sliver lining, which, just for your information, is silver lining. Silver Lining, a non-profit organisation, will be funding researchers for solar climate intervention under the Safe Climate Research Initiative. And a snippet from this article, Michael Gerard from Columbia Law School said that climate change is an existential threat and it is time to consider all of the options. He says, I liken geoengineering to chemotherapy for the planet. If all else is failing, you try it. And obviously this is a very insensitive comment towards people with cancer, because you know just as much as what I do that some people, and chemotherapy is only used in cancer treatment, right? So many people with cancer opt to refuse chemotherapy and not take it because they prefer to have a better quality of life for their time remaining. So to liken geoengineering to be the chemotherapy for a planet with cancer, it's a bit dark, a bit insensitive, Michael Gerard. So, time to follow the money. Who is the Silver Lining, a non-profit organisation? We go to their website, Ensuring a Safe Climate, a National Imperative for Research in Climate Intervention and Earth System Prediction. And for those of you that haven't had a giggle at the name Silver Lining, do keep up. Who are they? The team? Kelly, the executive director at Silver Lining, is the co-founder and senior advisor for the Marine Cloud Brightening Project. You'll be familiar with that in Australia, if that's the same one. Kelly is also a technology entrepreneur. There's Alex, research director. He's had experience at JP Morgan. One of the advisors, Daniel, member of the Council on Foreign Relations. Another advisor, Steve, previously head of global investment research and chair of Global Markets Institute at Goldman Sachs. There is also Michael, an interesting advisor. He's basically an expert in lasers. You name it, he seems to have done it. Who are their funders? If we take a look at Pritzker Innovation Fund first, supporting the development and advancement of paradigm-shifting ideas to solve the world's most wicked problems. Now, with all of this sort of stuff, of course, the last people you'd expect to see in all these concerned people's world would be Harvard, the promoters of geoengineering. Ah, okay. No, there's Harvard. They're partners. Pritzker Partners, Harvard. You know what that means. So if we look for that LAD Climate Fund, I'm afraid couldn't really find anything on them. So let's skip to the 2040 Foundation and see what we can find on them. Well, on Cause IQ, found the 2040 Foundation. It's a public sector improvement organisation that was founded in 2013. As of 2019, they had $5.3 million in revenue and $143 million in assets. And if we look at their business trends, their revenue trend was $150 million in 2014. It went to zero in 2015, and in 2018 was zero. And the asset trends, 2013, zero, 2014, $150 million, coincidentally. And that's where it remains more or less in 2018. Financials for the 2040 Foundation in 2018, they gave nearly $8 million in grants to governments and organisations within the USA. In 2017, that was nearly $5 million. So if we click on the 2040 Foundation website, let's go and have a look at who are they. There's a couple of statements to do with the environment and an email address. But that's it. There's no other information on the website. But lower carbon, they seem okay, based in the UK. So that was another random journey through an innocent looking article, just through looking at some of the names, who are some of the people involved in that. Plenty of money being handed around again. The same network passing through. And on that note, we'll leave this week's news there. Take care, look after yourselves. Next video coming up, probably another off-topic COVID video. See you next time.